Roni, I go with you to work, my Alba. It is summer, heat, a leech, an ulcer. Papa has pills, a lecture, to heal the sick, the wounded. First stop, Mohammed in East Jerusalem. Damn good doctor, he tells me. Oh, he has a son. Don't look at him. Jamil, I go with him to work, my Abby. Sizzling summer heat clings to my back. He waits for Chaim, the pharmacist, to give him medicine. Magic to heal the sick, the wounded. A decent man, Abby tells me. Oh, he has a daughter. Don't look at her. Act one, main.
To work. I am my father's son, though I am a girl. But as firstborn of three, he gives me power like an amulet, cherishes my voice like it's the Bible, asks my opinion like it's a prize. But he still doesn't want to hear that I don't want to go to the army. He takes me to work so I can see the way things are.
To work. You are the son of my heart. For you I burn, Abi chants, like a prayer. All the while questioning why I read Rumi, why I look to the stars of solace, why the Quran is just a book and stars are my solace. He takes me to his work to make me stronger since he thinks my head is in the clouds.
The clinic. We enter through a dilapidated door. Me, Abba, and there are so many crying babies. Their tears could make rivers in the street, and the women, heads covered in burqas. I cannot see their eyes. Hands that hold their infants look rough and tired.
The clinic. How can Abi work here? It smells like piss. The wooden floor is splintering. There are too many dark and covered women in one small room. I feel like I'm going to vomit, but I have to pretend to be strong so Abi can think there is hope for me to become the doctor I never will become. So I pretend. Just to see the girl.
First glance. Who are you? You could be my brother, though I have no brother. But not the way I feel when I look into those dreamy hazel eyes of yours. Arab boy, with your gaze, my skin slips off of my heart.
First glance. Who are you? You could be my sister, with your blue eyes and the curls cascading past your shoulders. Israeli girl, I know you are looking at the muscles in my arm. I work with weights most days, which makes me feel like a man, something my Abi laughs at.
Naming things. I do not know your name. I see you somewhere, hands move like wind, your smile, slice of sun, crescent moon. I have named you Talisman. For the wishes buried in this burning lamp, to touch the bronze calluses that rise from your knuckles, to smell the aroma of your unshaven face, to feel your body blazing, to dream I can touch it.
Naming things. I do not know your name. I will call you girl, with the song in your voice. I am nicknamed Jordan. For the river, not a country. These countries separate us, so I am banished from the song and the sea. Me. Dinner chatter. We talk around the dinner table. Omi's good food, hummus, falafel, baba ganoush. For my sister, it is blah, blah, blah. I hear Abi whisper. He has a daughter, Jamil's age. Can you imagine? Ever? Never, Omi says. Never.
Dinner chatter. We talk around the dinner table. Ima's good food, hummus, falafel, baba ganoush. Blah, 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 too much blah, blah, while I think about the boy. I hear Abba whisper, he has a son, Ronit's age. Can you imagine, ever? Never, Ima says, never. West Bank settlement. Where I'm from, the men leave for the holy city while women make the kitchen their home. Where I'm from, the monastery of martyrs, once the most important of monastic centers, still stands. A reminder that the past is dead, though Arabs say it is still their land. Forgetting pilgrims once used this as a route between Jerusalem and Mecca. Where I'm from, I'm a pilgrim, since I dream out of my mother's kitchen, though my sisters pray to my mother's matzo balls. Where I'm from, school is our temple. Yes, there are 40 synagogues, but I revere the God of knowledge. We won the Israeli Ministry Education Prize twice, a national prize for our community's emphasis on green space, on playgrounds. I am from greenery and recreation and running races till my body is obsolete, on climbing jungle gyms to grapple with what? Where I'm from, everywhere I look, I see desert, long and sad, like a parched sky.
Two selves. Where I'm from, trees don't remember their roots, and hilltops don't remember their hills. I am the only son, half of a twin, who doesn't hear the signs of stars or the hunger of the day. I am from the love of school and poetry, from the river, words, and sky. I am Dr. Assad's son, the one who lives in Ramallah and East Jerusalem, the holiest of cities. It's strange to have two homes and still feel like I have none. I eat hummus and knaf nablusi and listen to Fairuz while I play on my oud and strum away the sorrow. Ma'ale Abdumim, I have named you Valley of the Confused. Arab and Jewish towns dot the hilltops. A bright sun shines even in winter. Grass everywhere and palm trees hovering over concrete roads. At the entrance to the city, two white doves with the word peace. But the aged olive tree is dried up in anguish because it belongs in my grandfather's backyard, not yours.
My mother, my Ima, whose womb was a garden of gardenias, golden girls, not sons to farm the land, but girls so strong that they make men move mountains. She loves me, her firstborn, proudly and fiercely. So she guards the fence like a lioness who could eat you with her eyes if you dare cross the land's casket.
My mother, my Omi, whose womb wrestled with war for years until twins tore through her womb like a bomb, beautiful relics, a son, a daughter. My sister wraps my mother in solace like a shawl, while I am restless. I am the eternal enigma the Quran can't answer.
Wolf. I have named my Abba Wolf because his hair is long enough to hide his feelings. I name him Wolf since there is something scary inside, ready to pounce, a predator, but devoted to his family. The wolf in him wanders over the fossils of his father, the fish, my grandpa, my Zadie. The fish, sometimes slippery. But Abba is different. He always returns to the desert, to his home. And sometimes he is soft and warm as a goat. He gives his pills freely to the clinic in Jerusalem. Sad, he says. Then he adds, he's Arab. Puzzling, my Abba the wolf. Father of light. My father, my Abba, Aish Hamashalat. Not Elohim, though sometimes his rage makes me feel that. Mostly he's Aviv Shalkol and Aviv Shalor until he discovers the
tiger. My father is a tiger, sleek on the outside, contained. He pounces on illness until it oozes out of you. Unless you die in his hands, then my father roars, laments, cries out to Allah, and my grandfather snarls, fool, for becoming a doctor in such futile times, for taking medical supplies from the hands of Jews. My great father, my Abi, Abi al-Azim, Abi Waba Tali Fel Yubarak Allah Abi. But if he knew how I dreamed the body of an Israeli girl, he'd fry me in the desert. Still I say, Ana Ohibyuka Ya Abi.
Ima, why doesn't she stand up to him? Tell him to leave me alone. She must have known the stories of the heart one time. Enough to know you don't always fall for the guy next door. Though that is who Jamil is. I have heard Papa say his name, truly.
Omi, why doesn't Omi stand up to him? Tell him I have grown beyond the trees, that I have my own heart, and that is what I answer. Didn't she ever fall in love? Or was that just a bitter pill she had to swallow?
I have named him Fish, though I cuddle in his arms like a cradle. He wants payback for the family lost in the Holocaust. He calls himself a Zionist. I call him fish for the way he stays in the deep waters where others would drown, admonishing his only son for giving out drugs to Arabs, smiling sadistically, drinking blood for breakfast. Imagine the pharmacist's profession. Imagine pills like poppies, sunflowers, roses, so many colors in Papa's garden, where people plan a pilgrimage, the Christians, the Arabs, always the Jews. Because their bones are broken, their bodies are battered, their heads are splitting open like a bleeding melon, and Abba's pills, fragrant flowers, offer a promise, if not for today, for tomorrow. When his Abi isn't looking. When he looks into my eyes, sneaking glances when we are at the clinic and his Abi isn't looking. I am the girl who laughs, who is free, the one who wears skirts and not pants like I always do. His gaze makes me want to undress so he can lift up and see what's beneath the dress.
When her Abba isn't looking, I have already left poems in her pockets, and she blows kisses when her Abba isn't looking. So I know she thinks of me as a man who would lift her skirt and love her, not the foolish boy my Abi thinks I am.
Let's meet. I hand him a slip of paper when Abba isn't looking. My name is Ronit, here is my number. Please call so we can make plans right away.
The gift. I feel this piece of paper, a gift, in my hand and pretend it is her body I am touching. Call me, I will.
Spices. Abba, let me get your coffee. And he gives me shekels, tells me not to be long. I've already texted Jamil to meet at the spice market. The big one with tamarind, curry, paprika, every delicious taste you can imagine. Salam, he greets me. Shalom.
Spice market. At first, we walk side by side, our bodies barely touching. I know a little Hebrew, she knows some Arabic. And as we continue walking down the narrow streets, our bodies are squeezed together. So we smile, graze hands, and the smells of spices holds me captive. I close my eyes and imagine the taste of tamarind in her mouth. Hands, Abi's hands, soft as dates. When he touches, the wounds of a child swept from the streets. But I remind him, some of our people wear bombs on their bodies. Because there is no electricity, no running water, no healthcare, he shouts. Then adds, our people wear bombs because of this. After, he wraps his arms, a blanket, around the burnt legs of a baby.
He touched my hand. Smiling morning replaces frowning night. Darkness stumbles out like a drunken man. Jamil's big bones startle my sight. If Abba only knew he touched my hand. Darkness stumbles out like a drunken man. Discover light inside his hazel eyes. If Abba only knew he touched my hand, my body rustles and it cries. Discover light inside his hazel eyes. A ceasefire already taking place. My body rustles and it cries. Dreams begin to run a race. A ceasefire already taking place. Between two bodies all ablaze. Dreams begin to run a race in our world's distorted maze.
Lightning strikes. The first thing that I notice are her eyes. As blue as day or sorrow they have rage. She teases me to enter my demise. If Abi only knew my heart is caged. As blue as day, or sorrow they have rage. From years of being told to stay away. If Abi only knew my heart is caged, a cacophony of hands that beg to stay. From years of being told to stay away. The monster fence with signs, do not trespass. A cacophony of hands that beg to stay. How could I dare to dream that this would last? The monster fence with signs, do not trespass. She teases me to enter my demise. How could I dare to dream that this would last? The first thing that I notice are her eyes.
What I love. Bones, singing over them, dancing when they are on the forest floor. Ima, the light of her eyes, the lightning of her voice. She taught me to be strong, but in Abba's presence, she is quiet, but he is a wolf. I love the wolf, the way that he cares for his family, his hands as large as leaves and their shadows. I love the drum, the whistle, the cry. Archaeology. Where is his fossil from? Jamil. I love Jamil. I gave to him with my heart before he requested it and would gladly give again. I would kill him with such cherishing, his bones beautiful like a bird's, ready to fly. What I love too. I also love music, dance, forgetting I have a body, thinking what I want to do with this body, sometimes fresh, not like the good girl my mom's made me out to be.
What I love, words, whispering over them, writing, filling up the page. Omi, she worries I am weak, like a broken well, that there is too much water. I love Abi, his hands, like dates sweetening our family, and the souk, where the kamaj is soft, as her body must be. Oh, to take her to El Berek, where there is a Turkish bath, no girls allowed, but I can dream, her body bathe in mine.
What I hate, that I have to pretend that I don't know him. How lame is that? That I have to ignore that I want him now, right now, not tomorrow.
What I hate, senseless school like history, that Jews are the enemy who robbed our land. I hate the ruins that they call my land, but what about our rights to water? I hate the way my twin is Omi's friend, the secret shared in hushed whispers. Ronit's alphabet, its letters are indecipherable, though she says mine are too. And when Omi says, where are you going? The mask of her burqa, a shroud for her face. I want to tell her, the desert, where I can cross the bridge of her body and feel Ronit's heat, so much heat, dripping with it. What I hate, that I can't say, let's do it now, anywhere, who cares where? That I smile when I want to tell my family where to go, so I don't have to hide.
To the market. Ima is curious why I suddenly want to do the errands, but she is so tired from the girls, she gives me a list. And I go to the Rami Levy market, where Arabs and Jews sometimes mingle, and there are natural foods, a bakery, a restaurant, Jamil.
A text, meet me at Gush Etzion Junction. And immediately I ask my mother for a list. He acts like a girl, Abi says. He should only know I have a girl, who I will meet at Rami Levy Market. We will hold hands and kiss with our mouths wide open. I say nothing, take the list and run.
Shell struck. They have named me Argonauta, Ima says, since I swam away so fast as if every dwelling was temporary. They say I have a land, but I do not feel at home. My shell is feather light but sturdy, strong compelled by an unknown sea.
Jordan. They may have named me Jordan, a pet name since I am a river. My feelings are liquid, even before Ronit. I was the boy without armor, because I love to read and write. But I also listen to Coldplay. So why say I melt? Are my prayers too petrified for you?
Sweet statue. I'll name you sweet statue with bronze skin. I ask the sun to step aside since the glare is blinding. At night, the full moon reappears. Still no one notices. I'm whiter than the new snow upon a raven's back. No one sees the full moon and its treacherous treason.
No more. No more tender-boned Jamil. No more. So tired of being the sweet boy like a shepherd who herds his sheep. Soon, I will be a ram who watches the orchard, hangs out its lanterns. The dead come stumbling by in shrouds. Nothing can stay bound or be imprisoned. Not me.
Hunger. I'm hungry for burika, stuffed with cheese oozing on the plate. Maybe labani, spicy or dripping, or jakun, drunk with mint tea. Ima grinds the nuts for the baklava just like his omi. Then why must I eat alone?
Hunger. I am hungry for kanaf nablusi, the queen of Arabic sweets, or date-filled semolina cookies, the magrud of pistachios, baklava, cake, and hummus. My omi grinds the chickpeas with the heart of her knuckles, same as Ronit's Ima. I am hungry for Ronit and thirsty too.
The enemy. My Abba has named you the enemy, one who births bombs and throws them out the window, the one who would smile like a knife just to see blood, blood lips and rivers of red. for Israelis to swim in. Look at his eyes, they would say. They are black slits. But he has light eyes. And when I look, all I see is an invitation to gaze at the moon in your night.
The enemy. My Abi has named you the enemy. Such a ruthless thief to steal land when no one is looking, change locks, change the keys. And I have the key to prove my father right. But when he tells me your eyes hold lies, I know he doesn't understand those blue flecks are rockets asking me to fly away.
Streetwalk. Yes, I am coming to work with Abba today. Did you get my text? Abba almost grabbed the phone from me and growled like a lion when I pulled back. Next time, he snarled. We will stroll through East Jerusalem, through narrow streets and small markets. We will feed each other nuts, fruits, oranges, from which we will suck the juices dry. Coffee. Tell your Abi he needs coffee with cardamom, hot and steamy, the way I like your kisses.
My sister told Omi, did not get your first text, since my sister ratted me out. I tremble thinking she told Abi too. His temper is brutal. He'd never let me come to work with him again. Omi grabbed my phone and kept it for 2 days, but I had already deleted the messages. I might need to talk to you, Abi, she shrieked. About what? I challenged her. And finally, she shoved the phone in my face. Can you imagine if she saw the message where I said I wanted to eat the fruits from your garden? Coffee, yes, piping hot.
Text. This fence you cannot cross, you cannot see through. It is 25 feet of concrete, will soon be 435 miles long around Qalqilya, the West Bank barrier. There is no separation barrier between you and me.
This wall is so high. 25 feet of concrete, 435 miles long. I can only imagine you on the other side, your arms swinging freely in the summer wind. An afternoon walk, walking the narrow alleyways of Zion, eating murtabak, Yemeni mutton-filled pancakes, hearing the chants to prayer, the Jews, the Arabs, smelling the fresh sizzling beneath the heated afternoon sun and tasting it. We are together, and we look like siblings. No one knows how burnt I am around her. Shihab, so be it. I am the Shihab. Still, there is a sky out there, Ronit. And what a fool not to plant in this garden of goodness. Discard the sheets of hate you have all tried to plant in me, my people and her people too.
Other gardens. It is too rash, too unadvised, too sudden, too like the lightning to call this love, the summer's ripening breath. Right now, we are flower buds in the summer air, but next time, we'll deflower.
Here, we can hold hands, walking through the narrow street. No cars allowed, only Ronit and Jamil. Today, Ronit is an Arab with her head covered.
Tomorrow, Jamil pretends to be Israeli. There is no separation barrier between us.
Sun, Ronit is the fair sun in the east, the one who kills the envious moon. I can answer her eyes, but Chaim is looking. And though she may be bold and brazen, her eyes still twinkle, tempt me to touch them.
Moon, Mohammed looks too, even though I touch my eyes to the ground. He does not understand the wardrobe of feelings. I ask Jamil, oh, swear not by the moon, the inconsistent moon, because the moon wears a mask while I undress my face daily. Kiss. Then I have my lips, the scent that they have took. I will take yours as mine and swear by you, not the ambiguous moon or the dead night. I swear by you because you hear me cry and understand the ruins of language that stand in the way like a contamination. But then we kiss. Forget night and bombs. Forget the whole confusing journey.
Light. Her eyes are mine. They light the oil of lamps. They are fueled by fear and longing. They suffer silently watching the forbidden fence between our people and our bodies.
Keys. I have heard about keys, ancient, cryptic, ones that have traveled across oceans, guarded like gold. No one will enter this house. My heart already swings open.
Keys. I've heard about keys. My grandfather keeps hidden carefully in the womb of a vault. It once opened the door to a house on land. You love, but don't own.
Act two, complications.
A walk in the woods. I know a place where there are trees and the people at this checkpoint are lazy, so we can walk the woods and finger flesh, not just a kiss.
A walk in the woods. I love this place where we can hide. But what if Abby comes looking for me, and I am caught in the embrace of your beautiful branches?
Another glance. I hold my palm to his like a kiss. My lips have the sin that they took. But his name is enemy, though Abba calls him Jamil. I know what's in the shadows of the words he doesn't say. I pray for another name aside from Arab. Abba says I can go on a bus and someone wearing a bomb could blow me up. Jamil's family would never, would they?
Homeless, I live here. This is my home. Don't call me permanent resident. Allow my father his doctor's rights. Give him some benefits, not others. Hundreds of olive trees chopped down, burnt, uprooted, homeless. How could Israelis chop down trees to build settlements? Ronit's family would never. Could they?
Olive Garden. You say you are water. My bounty is as boundless as the sea. My love is deep. But the land is passed down from my Zaidi. We can share it, but don't ever say I plucked the olive from your tree.
Another garden. Where is my garden? Where is my secret Sinai? My beloved olive trees, entire groves erased, uprooted by the contractors who built the forts, the fence, taking land away from our farmers, my landscape obliterated by the other side Ronites.
Text. You can say land was taken from your farmers to build the fence. The olive trees were uprooted. This makes me sad. This makes me scared.
I didn't want to make you scared. Sad. It's just when we talk about whose land it is, as the rockets fly from Gaza and one lands near your home, I want you to understand there are no answers except for us. No work today. Last night, a bomb went off on a bus in Tel Aviv. The night before, a rocket came near our settlement. So Abi says, I must stay home. I must stay safe. But my only safety is with you. I got your text, and I hear Abi grumbling, so I knew it was bad. They will retaliate, he shouts. And I knew he was talking about Israelis. I knew. He just doesn't get it. Our only danger, Ronit, when we are apart.
It's complicated. This fence, I know it's wrong, but so are bombs people strapped to themselves, blowing up our land, our people, and the rockets from Gaza, and the harsh words and the winds of the world, that Israel is not a place nor a people.
It's complicated. I am not a terrorist, not my Abi either. I pray to Allah to ban the evil spirits waiting at the door, yet everywhere I turn, a checkpoint. So I can't leave, nor can I stay.
The Mount. My Iman tells me King Solomon built the first temple here in 957 BCE. It is the holiest site for prayer, ensures us there is God. Sure, the Dome on the Rock, a large mosque were built too, in 668, was completed in 692, but when the Israelis won the Six-Day War in 1967, it was ours again forever.
Dome of the Rock. My Omi tells me Umayyad Caliph Abd al-Malik built the Dome of the Rock. Our people believe in its holiness, the Islamic miracle of Izhir and Miraj. His son built the huge mosque at the end of the Haram. Now we enter our mount in one of 10 gates from the old city. We pray to reclaim our place in the world. You don't understand. I began in black stones and subterranean waters. Allah spoke to me and said, claim this soil. Its heart beats in your breast. I know the Quran is just a book, but it is here. The Prophet Muhammad made his journey to the throne of God.
You don't understand. I'm Israeli. I swear by my land. It is my badge. I wear it proudly. It was the land of my ancestors, and in 1948, my Zaidi claimed it as his own. The Temple Mount is also mine. It is where Abraham almost sacrificed his son. Nothing more holy than this.
Not just about. I am not just about Rumi. I am also hip-hop. Damn, and even Ibrahim Gunaim really loved Min Irhabi, who's the terrorist, surely not me. I am about Ramallah, the street's dreams of joining protest my Omi has forbidden. Protests that say there should be a two-state solution, a home for Israelis and a home for Palestinians. Each its own state, so we can walk the streets in safety.
Not just about. I'm not just Shakespeare. I'm nicotine, Asaf Avidan. I'm music, moonlight, cafes, dancing on the beach. And I might join the street fights for a two-state solution if Ima weren't watching. And didn't ask me about you, Jamil. She wants to know who you are, cringes when I say Mohammed's son. The rockets. Rockets, suicide bombers, blood on the side of a bus. Abba looking at me through slanted eyes like he knows I have something to hide.
Checkpoints, work permits not given, land taken away. Abba looking at me with angry eyes. Like he knows I have something to hide. A walk in East Jerusalem. Finally, after days of rockets from Gaza, no casualties, Israelis sent gunfire right back.
But here we are, holding hands, sipping mint tea, playing footsies with our toes.
Making believe the rockets on the side of the road are just pretend.
I shouldn't, but I will. I can't, but I must. Your politics, a plague I have to stay away from. There must be a better match. Yet I look at you. You could be my brother, my friend, my lover.
My head says this is dangerous territory. Yet each night the cloud of my pillow takes us to a place where your eyes and mouth invite me for supper. So I stay, not away, my sister, friend, lover.
A day in the desert. My cousin will drive us to Mitzramon, where we can shed our skins at last. Remember, you're Israeli if someone from the army should stop us. It will be terrifically hot.
A day in the desert. Omi says, you're going where with Khalif? The desert? Why? Just to see it? She mutters beneath her breath and cries, it is so hot, and there are so many Jews there.
Joined bodies. We can do it in the desert. No one will see us. No one can smell us. We probably smell the same and taste the same. Let's try. Now. My cousin says she will take a walk and swears she won't tell Abba. Land. A wrinkle upon the foot of my land. No need for shoes upon my land. My holy forefathers prayed for this land. They wandered like nomads on their land. Now you dare to enter on my land. Now I bid you entry inside my land.
Built of bones. There is nothing but the body built of bones. When I find myself beside you, I rise like bones. From the dead and my desire, it grows like bones. I dream of you daily where I am in your bones. They can bury us together and we'll share bones.
Water. In such dry land, some water. Well, I dream of tasting your water. My body withers in brutal summer, so what I need is water. You say you're always parched and yearn for water, but if my body's yours, you share my water, and if your body's mine, I'll need no water.
River. My nickname is Jordan. I was named for a river. My Abi doesn't know me since I feel like a river. These Jerusalem streets are hot, so I pine for a river. My body is even hotter, so I cry for a river. When Ronit invades my sleep, she crosses into my river.
Desert. There is a whirlwind of sand in the desert, but I find your hand in the desert. My bones are brittle until I see you in the desert, and I am withered, but then I dance in the desert. The air is hot and heavy, but I do not care in the desert. My body sweats a storm, which I give you in the desert.
In a tomb. When I do not see you, my heart is in a tomb. The whisper of your words I carry in my tomb. The shadow of your smile creeps out from the tomb. The warmth of your body without it, I am a tomb. If I can't be with you, bury me in the tomb.
Fences. You can't cross my fence, my land. There is a fence, a gate, a body that separates us. But I can cross yours. walk the streets like a coyote, a Jew, and an Arab. I dream of escape into the desert where we look the same, two bronze statues, no fences, no land, naked with the sand. Remember the other day?
Fear. What if I am put in a tomb and there is no air to breathe? What if Ronit never comes and I sleep with my ancestors' bones? Should I shriek like a mandrake torn out of earth? Should I curse this land we both own?
Fear. My only love sprung from my only hate. That is garbage since I'm watching dates grow in his land, in my land, imaginary place, our land, where petals pray for hate to perish, where we drink mint tea together, hours in a cafe. Away. I watch our letters collide. They're so different. Your language stutters syllables in my mouth. I can't always read the bones in your skull. I'm an exile, don't you know? Good thing I know some Arabic and you know more Hebrew. But now I'm ready to migrate somewhere, anywhere, away, away, away.
Safe in my skin. Let's erect monuments, new ones. No more edifices of sorrow. Let the sheep dig their feet in the sand while I have dervish dreams. I'm ready to be home safely in my skin.
Ima knows. I know why you run to the clinic, Ima says. It is that boy, and I say nothing. Inside, I tremble for the wolf, my Abba, who could pounce on Jamil, never take me to work with him again. I cannot look in her eyes for fear they will betray me. If Abba finds out, you can forget it.
Omi knows. I know why you run to the clinic, Omi says. It is that girl, and I say nothing. What if she told Abi, who has vengeance buried deep within his heart? I cannot look in her eyes for fear they will betray us. She grabs my phone. If Abi finds out, forget it.
Meteors. That light is not daylight. It is some meteor the sun exhaled. Don't leave for Sinai. Stay. When we leave, it will be together. Names. Refuse your name. Discard it in the sewer, and I will banish my name too. What's in a name? That which we call a rose by any other word would smell as sweet. Trade in your name. Our skins are the same. No one will know the difference.
A father's lament. First we have Hayam, and then we have Mohammed, the two dads.
My daughter, she has marbles in her head. She says it's love, but no one is in sight. The day is done, has stolen all her light. She'd rather read and moan and stay in bed. My wife, she cries, her eldest is bereft. These months are like a dragon in disguise. I feel her fire. She fills our house with lies. It's not Ronit. There must have been a theft. This desert's dust has answered in our home. The other children learn to stay away. I'll take her pain and make of it a clone. My head fills up. Oh, woe. A woeful day. Our garden's filled with agony and groans. Please tell me, dear Ronit, what can I say? Please tell me, dear Ronit, what can I say? Look at our land that's bursting through the sun. I want to smile before you take your run. This constant talk you have to run away. You speak of peace, but I am a peaceful man. You call me wolf. Whenever did I bark? Not like your Zadie, who you call a shark. I give free drugs to Arabs in the land. I long for you to thirst, but not to drown. My cherished girl, who wanders without aim. A speck of sand, who's searching to be found. And desert dreams are hidden in the ground. It makes no sense to say we are the same. It makes no sense to say we are the same. No plague upon this house, but I believe the message of the sword that makes us grieve. We all wear masks. But sometimes there is blame. Hima struggles, yet leaves you all alone. So soon you'll be out fighting in the war. She keeps you busy with homework, and with chores. Her back is turned to melodies and moans. Yet I cannot. Her love for Arabs grows. It cannot be that boy Muhammad's son. Still Cupid's arrow hit her body shows. No need grows thinner. I can see her bones. If it's an Arab, then there will be blows. If it's an Arab, then there will be blows. Ema says, you fool, she's scared to go fight. The warrior will hold the gun with might. Yet inside of her heart is still a rose. She's always been a model for the girls. So smart in school, so tapestries of dreams. When Hannah cries, Veronique can stop her screams. A beauty too, with gorgeous auburn curls. I wonder if we're viewing the same child. I see a wanderer, a restless soul. The blaze inside her eyes is something wild. And I am Haim, protector is my role. My temperament is anything but mild. And I must help to make my Ronit whole. And I must help to make my Ronit whole. My wife picks dates, says what she needs is food. Ronit's a nosher, but nothing cures this mood. I think that it's time to set a goal. Leave me alone, she screams like a creature. I'm thinking about math and of the night. When darkness comes, there's no sleep, no fight. Stop with your speeches, you're not my teacher. I feel the shadows over dark hills. Unwieldy, slow, heavy, and pale as lead. I must get back to work and pay the bills. Ronit tells me she has to go to bed, and all I see is sadness, no more thrills. Maybe such sweet sorrows in my head. Maybe such sweet sorrows in my head. But not when all she dreams is of the dark. To start a brawl, all she dreams of is of the dark. To start a brawl, make certain of my mark. There's a chance the boy and man is dead. I won't be deaf to pleading and excuses. A boy has taken Ronit from her home. As soon as the moon hides, Ronit she roams. Not tears or prayers shall purchase our abuses. To stop their love before it's too late. For when he's found, their hour is his last. I entertain revenge for all my hate, with hopes that with this poison he'll go fast. She dreams him as her history, her mate, without a thought of history, our past. Without a thought of history, our past, so much of family dead from war. Aunts and uncles 6 feet beneath the floor, many layers of grief already cast. Ronit has journeyed to the other side. In shadows where she whispers all in black, when Hannah talks to her, she turns her back. Hannah seeks empty caves for tears to hide. My little Shayna beds the enemy. It does not matter that her parents bleed. However, did he find the blessed key? Inside our home, her heart a lethal deed. Jamil, if he's smart, has time to flee. Venom's grown a forest from a small seed.
My son, it seems his head is in the earth. He says it's love, but no one is in sight. The day is done, has stolen all his light. Poems and music are his friends and his worth. My wife, she cries, her boy is so bereft. He dozes on pillows made of tears. I'm struggling with patience, so many fears. Jamil in his cocoon feels like a theft. He's clearly in torment in day and night, indifferent to clouds as they pass by on a camel traveling far away. Jamil, your probing fills us with such fright. When we ask you what is wrong, you simply sigh. Please tell me, dear Jamil, what can we say? Please tell me, dear Jamil, what can I say? Hunger holds our land inside its jaws. Your mind does somersaults and questions laws. This constant talk, you have to run away. There is no peace when we don't have our land. You question everything I say and do. Omi watches your face and she feels blue. My heart is carefully vaulted in the sand. I try to think that no one is to blame, for Chaim is my friend and not my foe. My son, distracted, while I stand so proud. It makes no sense to say we are the same. My hands, swift weapons, try not to come to blows, but my grief about my people, that is loud. My grief about my people, that is loud. When they are held as captives of the land, when they have claims to every speck of sand, each craftsman and his craft, he is so proud. I hope you do not sway to hear that side. Your dreamy eyes are drawn to mountains high, as if your spirit climbs and you would sigh. When Chaim's girl stands near, you're on a ride. I touch my hands and hope that I can heal, but there's no magic motion that I can make to bring my son back to my special view. It's Chaim's girl who's unearthed what my boy feels. His body bursts, politics he forsakes. His brain is shrouded, he doesn't know what's true. His brain is shrouded, he doesn't know what's true. I'm busy treating patients and their wounds when Jews are injured. My hands become the moon, since sickness is my sign, it's what I do. If Chaim were my patient, I would heal the treachery of blood and all the rest ignoring prayers of Allah. I am best in eyes of dust and gloom. I touch with zeal. Yet so much death is smoking in the street. The earth, she mourns from morning until dusk. The men, they wander aimlessly around. The grief of all my people is complete. The spirit of humanity a husk. The heavy weight of sorrow leaves no sound. The heavy weight of sorrow leaves no sound. The patients line the halls like goats and herds. Jamil's words sing softly, must be heard. Voices of the maimed lie on the ground. The sun at dusk becomes my enemy, with many more sick patients in the street. They moan sour dreams like animals in heat, while Jamil, my beloved, yearns to flee. The children and their hunger pierce my soul. They dream about butterflies that take them far, far away. Such dreams are myths on old abandoned trees. Jamil, my son, he sits on sorrow's hole. He's so entitled to be birthed another day. Lacerations deep inside, so he's not free. Lacerations deep inside, so he's not free. The cypress trees, they limp across the land. The heat grows angrier upon my land. Roni has captured my son in her sea. I wonder if they think that this is love. I need to shake the earth out from his head. Fear fills up my nights I cannot shed. I'll banish Roni's sunrise from above. Embroidered in my heart is this torment. Must stop before this is too late. Behind the hills a very rocky rage. The sky has ripped the flesh and now it's bent. The valley of my soul is filled with hate. Jamil does not hear words from ancestors' graves. Jamil does not hear words from ancestors' graves. He doesn't see our paradise is dead. He doesn't see betrayal in our bed. He doesn't feel the anguish of the waves. Jamil has journeyed to the other side, where nightmares seek refuge in all black. When Layla talks to him, he turns his back. Layla seeks empty caves for tears to hide. My only son, he beds the enemy. It does not matter that our people bleed. However, did she find the blessed key? Ronit, if she's smart, has time to flee. Inside our home, his heart, a lethal deed. Venom's grown a forest from a small seed.
Act 5, onward.
We have to go.
I know.
Abba says he is ready for the kill.
Abi says that too. He's scary.
So is Abba. I'm not sure what he's capable of.
Oh, I know Abi has this ugly rage inside of him.
So why are you so sad, Jamil?
You're sad too.
I know. My Abba, my Ima, even though Abba is scary now.
For sure, my Abi, my Omi, even though Abi is scary now.
And what about my sisters?
My sister too? We'll be leaving everything to be together.
Don't be so melodramatic, Jamil.
It's the truth.
What choice do we have?
Nothing. Nothing. We have to find another place.
Where we can dance on the beach?
where we can just hang out.
Where we don't have to hide. I'm sick of hiding.
Me too. How did it get this bad?
I guess they're idiots.
Ronit, it's not like you to talk this way. And it's our parents you're talking about.
Not just our parents. Our countries, the world.
Will it be better in Jaffa?
Jaffa might be for a little while, but not for long.
Why?
I spoke with my aunt, Natanya. She is such a good doctor. She is the one who will give us a new look. She says that our parents might find us in Jaffa. She also said there has been tension lately. Israelis and Arabs have always lived side by side, until now. Lately, some Palestinians have taken up with knives, and some Israelis have taken up with arms. Not good.
I'm scared of surgery, and scared of this fighting you're talking about.
Don't be silly, Jamil. Hair, makeup, dye, and fighting, forget it. There's always been fighting.
Why is your aunt Natalia willing to do this?
She knows all of this is wrong.
Then why does she stay in Israel?
It's her country. She loves her country. It's the only place she knows.
But she's willing to help us escape?
She loves me more.
What if your Abba is suspicious and threatens her?
He would never do that. And if he did, she would never tell. Besides, she may not know where we are. Only your Uncle Faiz will know.
Faiz? I'm worried he will get into trouble.
He agreed to get us these papers. You said he has done this before, given people brand new identity papers?
He has, but I hate to lie.
Forget it. Live with it. What have we been doing for these past few months?
I can't believe you just said that, Ronit.
It's not like we have a choice.
We don't, but I do not feel like a Jack.
You think I feel like a Rachel? It's so weird, it makes me laugh.
But I do not feel like laughing. I keep on thinking our parents will think we are dead.
I feel dead, Jamil. I feel dead when the rockets go off.
I feel dead when children die on both sides.
I feel dead when I can't see you.
Me too.
Why are you so quiet now, Jamil?
What if we end up in America? Faiz knows many people in America.
Gee, I don't know.
It has to be better there.
You think so?
Yes, it has to be better.
Perhaps.
Why perhaps?
America has problems too. Every place has problems.
We can hold hands.
We can touch.
No country to contain us.
No borders, no boundaries.
Faiz will make this happen.
Natanya will make this happen. Ronit?
Jamil?
Rachel?
Jack?
A new country?
Free of distant rocks that rage on angry grounds.
Hand in hand, we can walk.
You, me, kissing outside of shadows. It will be nice, Rachel.
It will be wonderful, Jack.
One day we can reclaim our names.
But for now, peace.
Love.
Peace.
I want to thank my very wonderful cast. Chris, Bibin, Marissa, and Lewis, fantastic people from the theater department. Who had to actually come in during intersession to do a dress rehearsal or a rehearsal because there wasn't much in the way of dress other than having to wear black. But they had to come in during intercession and other times as well. Even though it was a stage reading, we really had to get this just right with the lighting and the staging and everything. And they were troopers, and Irvin was a trooper.
Irvin.
Our lighting person. I would also like to thank our filmmakers, Jonathan and
Chris Brown. That's his real name.
Chris Brown. I want to thank my wonderful agent, Mersini, my terrific agent, my editor, Ben, and Mabel, his assistant. Thank you for coming. Thank you for supporting this very wonderful vision. When I started it, I had such hope for the world. And it was my vision of peace and love, and yes, things would be different in America,
and some of that has been diminished, but we will rise. That's what they say, we will rise. And so we will, with words, with language, and with what I have said, we build bridges. That's what literature does. We build bridges, we dismantle walls. That's what this book does, and that's what language does, and that's what we all do every day. So thank you, my friends, my students, my wonderful husband, Ira, my wonderful daughter, Samantha. Thank you, everyone. And I cannot forget, is Greg here? Gregory Shank and Dave Covington and City College Center for the Arts for sponsoring this event, for giving us the space and the time. And poor Greg, who I hacked all the time, we need to have rehearsal. And he said, how many days do you need to rehearse this? It's a stage meeting. Well, we have to get it just right. And he really put up with me, which is a remarkable thing in itself. I want to thank all of you for coming. We have time for just a few questions, because I want to also sign books for any of you who have purchased books. So, any questions? And it could be for the audience members as well. I really feel, and I want, they've been so terrific. I really feel, I felt this yesterday, that when I was watching them, I was no longer watching the actors. I felt like I was watching Ronit and Jamil and Chaim and Mohammed, which is a terrific feat. Thank you. Anyone? A few years ago, it was actually, I think from the time I signed the contract till it was published, it was a year, and it was 2 years prior to that. It really took me a long time to write, and partly because I'm limited by my teaching schedule. Because once I'm teaching, and my students in the audience know I'm teaching, I'm there for you. And that takes up a lot of time and energy. I did a lot of research, a lot. Ronit means grace, and Jamil means beauty. And I like the idea of the merging of grace and beauty. I felt I was looking for the perfect Israeli and Arabic names, ones which would complement one another. And you're a Jamil, you're a student in my class who's a Jamil, and I said, wow, there's a Jamil girl and a Jamil boy. How about that? Do you know what your name is?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you why I decided to go so far. I reread Romeo and Juliet before I wrote this book, attempted to start writing this book, and then looked at Romeo and Juliet again. There is a lot more than you probably know. And so I felt I was just going to go with it in that way. I mean, why not? It's really about two teenagers in the throes of adolescent passion. And it's only the political landscape, the families which are enemies that get in the way. And it's the same, I see this as not necessarily a story about Israel and Palestine, but I see this as a story for today's world in every which way. And I think it truly is. There are always families who won't want to see their teenagers together. And yet the young people will, thank heavens, always find a way to build that bridge. I think I finished it, to be honest, and it felt like poetry is meant to be read out loud, and this is really a book of poetry. I think when you hear poems read out loud, and I know there are a lot of MFA students in the audience, a lot of poets in the audience, that you'll agree that you hear something different when it's read out loud. And I shared this with my agent yesterday when they were reading. Yesterday they really amped it up when we were rehearsing. And there was one point, I have seen these words over and over. Ben's been a great editor, so I edited and edited again and edited again. And I know these words at the back of my hand, and yet when they were speaking them yesterday, I started crying. I really felt them
deeper inside of myself in a way I never had before. So obviously, hearing them spoken in another voice, other voices rather, really made quite a difference to me. I think it's meant to be performed. And I'm happy to say that Brooklyn College will now be doing it. There's a organization, political organization, Go BK, Go Brooklyn Arts. They want to do it for to combat Islamophobia, and now Poets House is interested in it as well. So I hope it will be going all over. I told these guys they're on board. So that's very exciting because now I can't imagine taking on another Ramit or Jamil or Chaim or Mohammed. I did say that I said I wanted the father's voices to have a different poetic form.
Yeah.
And so I knew I would use a crown of sonnets. And I was really, some of you know this, I was really inspired by the Royal Crown of Sonnets, and some of you have taken a class where I taught Aretha Emmett Till, Marilyn Nelson's Royal Crown of Sonnets. So I just thought the sonnet form does something very, very different. So I was committed to that, and I thought that's what would distinguish the dad's voices.
Yeah, the repetition was great.
And these guys were great. Mahant, I mean, you didn't just need the yarmulke and the kippah. Like, they just got those characters down. If truth be told, I was raised by my dad. That was part of it. And I always think that stories and family narratives always focus on the mother. And I wanted to have these dads work together so and actually be acquaintances, even friends of sorts. That was very central to my story. So I decided to center the family dynamics on fathers who have very different relationships with their children than mothers do. And equally important, I really believe that. Equally important. Good question. Like I said, I think it started with that my father raised me, and he was central in my life. And I really think that a father should and can take an equally important role. So I wanted
more agency in the world. Does it stem from the culture that you're portraying and the workers' cultures?
I think I was thinking about Romeo and Juliet a lot, Alyssa, when I wrote it, that because I think obviously mothers have great agency in this. I mean, naturally.
I know.
But it started with Romeo and Juliet, and then it moved into I'm putting the moms in the background because my father raised me, and that was an important part of my life. So it served many purposes. You've been a terrific audience. My wonderful friend Kathy, I know, has to skip out, but it was so generous of her to come. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. I know I should.